My name is Bernadette and this is BF Creations on YouTube. In this video, I continue my Bernadette's gourd creation series with a step-by-step gourd project. I'll show you how to carve and embellish a gourd into a fresh, beachy creation. This project will give you a lesson in wood burning, power carving, sanding, coiling, alcohol dyeing, and making texture with real sand. First, you'll need to cut the top off a clean, dried Martin House gourd. Clean the inside out and then paint it black. Then draw out your pattern as shown. Wood burning. With a knife tip, slowly follow along the lines of your pattern. Don't press down too much. Let the heat do most of the work. Clean off the tip as you go along. Sandpaper will work just fine. Power carving. I'm using a variable speed Dremel rotary tool with flex shaft attachment and a large tooth carbide burr. Carve out all the area within the lines you just wood burned. You will only need to carve about an eighth of an inch to a quarter of an inch deep, deeper if that's the look you're going for, and if your gourd is thick enough. Power sanding. I'm using my Dremel rotary tool with the right angle attachment and a sanding mandrel with an 80 grit disc. Keep in mind there will be a lot of gourd dust. Wear proper safety gear and make sure there is sufficient ventilation. Dyeing or inking. I'm using Adirondack alcohol inks and the color Stream, but any nice turquoise blue will do. Spread the ink dye over the gourd with paper towel. You may want to protect your hands with plastic or rubber gloves. Now dab a bit of rubbing alcohol here and there over the ink. Just your finger will do. It will make the ink run, but that's just what you want. After the ink has dried, seal the gourd with acrylic sealer. Coiling. I'm using a large-eyed needle and artificial sinew cut at workable lengths. 1/8 inch thick seagrass, no need to cut a length of the grass until you're done coiling, and a pin vise with a 1/16 drill bit. Start by drilling holes evenly spaced around the rim of the gourd. It doesn't matter about spacing nor the number of holes. You'll need two holes to start your coiling. Start by pulling your needle through one of the two holes and then leave a tail. Place the end of your seagrass right between the holes, then go back through the other hole with your needle and pull tight. And then make a knot on the inside. Continue stitching the seagrass onto the gourd by taking the needle through the next hole from the inside to the outside. Go over the grass, then go right back into the hole, pulling tightly. When you have gone all the way around the rim once, keep going and do another round with the grass. Take your needle through a hole from inside to outside, go over and around the grass, then back into the same hole. Pull tight and there you go. For the third round, you'll need to drill another set of holes. Just follow the placement of your first set of holes. Then stitch the grass onto the gourd in the same way as the first round you did. After you've completed the three rounds or rows of seagrass, and you stitched your way back to where you first started, take your grass and bend it into a circle. You can see I'm stitching the seagrass slowly around using the holes that were made previously, and I'm turning the seagrass right around into a circle. And I'm going over the loose end, the very first end, that I stitched onto the gourd. This will finish off the rim very nicely and add to the whole look of the gourd. And there you go. See what a nice touch that is? But you're not done yet, not with stitching. You'll need to make a bunch more holes. Just follow the video for placement of them all. And as you can see, the stitching is pretty much the same thing as I showed you with the first row of seagrass. You pull the needle through the hole from inside to outside, then go around or over your seagrass and then back into the same hole. Gluing shells. I used a large assortment of mostly cockle and scallop shells, all different colors. Attach the shells with E6000 glue or epoxy, and then hold in place with masking tape. Sand texturizing. Mix together white glue, beach sand, and a bit of water. Dab the mixture onto the small carved area, the one you didn't sand smooth, and then let the glue dry. Thanks for watching. Thumbs up if you love this gourd transformation from a simple dried gourd to a fresh, beachy creation. Created and edited by me, Bernadette Fox. Music by Josh Woodward. And make sure to subscribe to my channel for more DIYs about art, crafts, gardening, and much more. Hey, and why wait? Check out my latest videos right now. And stay connected. See social links below.